وحقيقة إن الناظر في أحوال الأمة اليوم يجد أن وعد الله قد تحقق في أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وذلك لأخذهم بأسباب الإيمان التي تزيده، وابتعادهم عن الأسباب التي تنقص الإيمان، لأن الواحد فيهم كان يحمل إيمانا كالجبال، لا تهز الشبهات ولا تضعفه الشهوات، فكانوا من أولياء المتقين كما وصفهم الله تبارك وتعالى بقوله: محمد رسول الله والذين معه أشداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم تراهم ركعا سجدا يبتغون فضلا من الله ورضوانا سيماهم في وجوههم من أثر السجود ذلك مثلهم في التوراة ومثلهم في الإنجيل كزرع أخرج شطأه فآزره فاستغلظ فاستوى على سوقه يعجب الزراع ليغيظ بهم الكفار وعد الله الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات منهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيما. وقال تعالى: للفقراء المهاجرين الذين أخرجوا من ديارهم وأموالهم يبتغون فضلا من الله ورضوانا وينصرون الله ورسوله أولئك هم الصادقون. ثم قال: والذين تبوأوا الدار والإيمان من قبلهم يحبون من هاجر إليهم ولا يجدون في صدورهم حاجة مما أوتوا ويؤثرون على أنفسهم ولو كان بهم خصاصة ومن يوق شح نفسه فأولئك هم المفلحون. وقال تعالى: لقد رضي الله عن المؤمنين يبايعونك تحت الشجرة فعلم ما في قلوبهم فأنزل السكينة عليهم وأثابهم فتحا قريبا. وقال: والسابقون الأولون من المهاجرين والأنصار والذين اتبعوهم بإحسان رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه وأعد لهم جنات تجري تحتها الأنهار الخالدين فيها أبدا ذلك الفوز العظيم. نعم.
أحسن الله إليكم. The Sheikh Abdullah, he says, and whoever looks into this affair at this time will realize that the Sahaba, Ridwanullahi alayhim, they fulfilled the Iman, they fulfilled Iman and its branches to the utmost. Because one of them would have fetched Iman in his heart that would not be shaken by shubuhat, by doubts, and it would not be weakened by desires. Rather, they would be firm and steadfast in their belief. As he says, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described them in his statement in the last ayah in Surah Al-Fath, he says, Muhammadur Rasulullah. Muhammad is, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is the messenger of Allah. وَالَّذِينَ مَعَهُ أَشِدَّاءُ عَلَى الْكُفَّارِ رُحَمَاءُ بَيْنَهُمْ. And those who are with him are harsh upon the disbelievers and merciful between them. تَرَاهُمْ رُكَّعًا سُجَّدًا. You will see them bowing in ruku' and in sujood, seeking after the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his pleasure. Their signs, or the signs of them, are their marks, are in their faces from the prostration. سِمَاهُمْ فِي وُجُوهِهِمْ مِنْ أَثَرِ السُّجُودِ. ذَلِكَ مَثَلُهُمْ. That is their example. That is their example, or their description in the Torah. And their description in the Injil is like that they are like a plant. كزرع أخرج شطأه فآزره فاستغلظ فاستوى على سوقه. Like a plant which starts with an offshoot, and then it strengthens, and then it becomes firm until it becomes like a strong tree. So it starts with an offshoot and then it becomes very firm, like a tree trunk. فاستغلظ فاستوى على سوقه يعجب الزراع ليغيظ بهم الكفار. And this starts, after it becomes like this, the people who are in plantation, the farmers, become happy about it. They're overwhelmed by it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and he made them like that, so that they will be a reason for enraging the kuffar. For enraging the kuffar. They will enrage the kuffar. Then Allah says, Allah has promised, وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْهُمْ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا مَغْفِرَةً وَأَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised those who believe and do righteous actions from them a forgiveness and a great reward. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the next ayah, لِلْفُقَرَاءِ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ الَّذِينَ أُخْرِجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ وَأَمْوَالِهِمْ. He says, for the poor immigrants who were thrown out of their own homes and their wealth because they were seeking after the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His pleasure. And they were seeking to help Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His messenger. Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الصَّادِقُونَ. They are the truthful ones. And then he says, وَالَّذِينَ تَبَوَّأُوا الدَّارَ وَالْإِيمَانَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. And those who took up places, who were living in places, and they accepted Iman before them, who had places before them, يُحِبُّونَ مَنْ هَاجَرَ إِلَيْهِمْ. The first ayah is talking about the immigrants. The second ayah is talking about the Ansar. They love those who came and made migration towards them. وَلَا يَجِدُونَ فِي صُدُورِهِمْ حَاجَةً مِمَّا أُوتُوا. And they would not find any kind of anything in their chests, anything whatsoever, for what these, the muhajirin, were given. وَيُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. And they would even prefer these, the muhajirin, over them, their own selves, even if they are in a state of need. وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصَةٌ. وَمَنْ يُوقَ شُحَّ نَفْسِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. And whoever is saved from the greed of his own self, then he is from the successful. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَقَدْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ يُبَايِعُونَكَ تَحْتَ الشَّجَرَةِ فَعَلِمَ مَا فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ فَأَنزَلَ السَّكِينَةَ عَلَيْهِمْ وَأَثَابَهُمْ فَتْحًا قَرِيبًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with the believers when they give the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the oath of allegiance under the tree. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew what was in their hearts. So He sent down upon them the Sakina, and He gave them a great victory. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ وَأَعَدَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي تَحْتَهَا الْأَنْهَارُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا ذَلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ. And those who were foremost and from the first of the immigrants and from the helpers, the Ansar, from the Muhajirin and from the Ansar, and those who follow them with goodness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with them and they are pleased with Him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for them gardens beneath which rivers flow. They will abide therein forever. That is the great reward. So these ayat, all of them show the virtues of the companions, رضوان الله عليهم. نعم.